The limestone of Portsmouth, laid down on granite, was pure, even-grained, and fossil-free. No record of the living things that had made it. No record of the nameless men who cleaved it from its granite bed and shaped it. All in all, a most desirable building stone.
Oh, I wish I had someone to love me. Someone to call me their own. I wish I had someone to live with. For I'm tired of living alone.
Writing this book, and Wayne will remember it too, sitting in my little attic office, and I really thought, you know, maybe 12 people would want to read this book. There's a lot of discussion right now about monuments and the appropriateness of monuments, because they're inclined to tell the story of victors and of the powerful. So I'm especially pleased at the installation of this monument that recognizes prisoners, men and women, who are particularly vulnerable to the abuses of power. Their voices are rarely heard, and when their voices are raised, they're too often dismissed by those who forget that they are human beings, like the rest of us, flawed, hopeful, despairing, desperate for human contact. The plaque, for me, acknowledges our irrepressible need for human contact. It acknowledges the humanity of the 90 to 150,000 men who called Kingston Penitentiary home. It acknowledges their place in our society and the work that they did cutting the stone to build their own cells and to build many of the houses that line the streets of what we like to call the Limestone City.
I'd fly to the arms of my lover, and there I would happily die.